Every scientific principle starts with a discovery. For example, radioactivity by Marie Curie. You probably knew that already because her name is very well known. But what about the name Eunice Newton Foote? We're going to tell her story today to see if you think her name should be well known too. Like countless other women in science, Eunice's discoveries were largely lost to history. She was born in America in 1819. She was a women's rights activist, an inventor, a painter, and an amateur scientist. And in 1856, she conducted an experiment that would foreshadow the greatest challenge currently facing life on Earth. We've replicated Eunice's 1856 experiment here at Questacon today. Now, it might look like I've just got two empty cylinders here, but this one is filled with normal air and this one with carbon dioxide. Earlier today, we got some dry ice, which is solid carbon dioxide, and put it in here where it's sublimed into carbon dioxide gas. Then we sealed up both cylinders, waited a few hours for them to reach the same temperature, which was about 20 degrees Celsius, and then we brought them outside into the sunshine. And now we're gonna see what happens. Did you see the temperature go up? When Eunice did this experiment in 1856, she noticed that the receiver containing the gas became itself much heated, very much more so than the other. And on being removed, it was many times as long in cooling. This led her to the conclusion that an atmosphere of that gas would give to our Earth a high temperature. And as we now know, carbon dioxide is the leading cause of climate change. The experiment that Eunice did is remarkably simple. In fact, you can try it for yourself at home. We have Lisa Harvey-Smith, Australia's Women in STEM Ambassador, to show you how.
Hi, I'm Lisa Harvey-Smith. I'm a scientist and I'm also the Australian Government's Women in STEM Ambassador. Now, I'm going to use some really basic equipment that you can find in your house to recreate Eunice Newton Foote's experiment about the effect of sunlight on the heating of air and carbon dioxide. Now, I've got two see-through bottles here. One I'm going to fill with air. Done. Put the lid on. This one is our air sample. Number two bottle I am going to fill with carbon dioxide. Now, I don't have any dry ice, so I've got to make some carbon dioxide myself, but luckily that's actually not too hard to do. I'm going to get some bicarbonate of soda, which you can buy in a supermarket, and some vinegar, just regular kitchen vinegar, and mix them together in a jar. So, I'm going to pop them in this glass jar here. Fizzy, fizzy, fizzy. This is what we're going to do. Create a chemical reaction inside the jar that is going to release bubbles. And those bubbles will be made of carbon dioxide. Now, this is really awesome. Bicarb, vinegar, go. Get the lid ready. Whoa, whoa. Okay, this is fizzy, so I'm gonna keep the lid on, oh, a little bit. Try and keep some of that air in there. Oh my goodness, this has gone drippy as well. I've made a mess. So you can see all the bubbles in there though, being created by the chemical reactions. And what I'm trying to do is get all those juices reacting together, so the vinegar and the bicarb, releasing all that wonderful carbon dioxide into the jar. I can start to actually hear it hissing and bubbling away. It's really, really cool. So now I've got a jar, shaky, 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 with some carbon dioxide in it. Now, I want to get that carbon dioxide into my bottle. So what I'm going to do is quickly pour it in using a little funnel. Now you can do this because carbon dioxide is a little bit heavier than air, so it actually falls downwards. So I'm going to try and do that and pour it in without getting any liquid in. Now that might not be enough, so I'm going to do another couple of batches, pour it into the bottle, seal it shut with the lid, and then place those into the sunshine, and we're going to measure how much they warm up. Right now the bottles have been in the sun for about 15 minutes, and I'm going to use a kitchen thermometer. This is a fancy one you use in milk or water to measure temperatures. I'm going to pop that in the top of the bottle and see what the temperature is inside the bottle of air. This has been out in the sun, remember. So the temperature is creeping up to around 26.5 degrees. Okay, 26.5. Now, carbon dioxide, let's see what the temperature is in there. Oh, that's creeping up a lot, very quickly. We are at 29.5 degrees. Wow, that is a big difference. So there's 3 degrees difference between a bottle of air and a bottle with mostly carbon dioxide in it. That's such a fascinating insight into what difference we have when we add carbon dioxide into an atmosphere in terms of the heating of the gas. A brilliant experiment. I hope you'll have a go at home and not take my word for it.
EUNICE's work was published in the 1856 American Journal of Science and Arts and was presented at a conference by a male scientist later that year. But despite this, her work was quickly forgotten. 3 years later, the Irish physicist John Tyndall published his own research on heat-trapping gases. And for the next 150 years, he would generally be credited as the founder of climate science. EUNICE is not alone as a woman and brilliant scientist whose work was forgotten to history. But we can celebrate her now. Celebrate her fierce curiosity and her passion to do science from home. And imagine what she could have done with her research if she'd had access to the same training and resources that were more accessible to men at the time. And imagine what a different situation our planet could be in if she'd had the opportunity to take her work further.
Today, for the International Day of Women and Girls in Science, we encourage you to seek out stories of brilliant scientists like EUNICE who have come before us. You can get some inspiration on the Future You website to see where science, technology, engineering, and maths could take you. And also have a look on the Women in STEM Ambassador and Questacon social media channels for more news and information about exciting upcoming events for primary schools. Have a great International Day of Women and Girls in Science.